Hi there! Welcome back to my channel. In case we haven't met before, I'm Anastasia, the founder from All You Can Face, and I'm passionate about teaching you how to exercise your facial muscles. Because what happens beneath the skin is equally important as what we put on top of it to stay looking beautiful and age gracefully. And today I want to talk about the 6 most common habits which we all do, which cause, in the long run, facial asymmetry. We will not only discuss the causes, but I will obviously also give you some tips on what to do about it, what to do at home to work on your facial asymmetry. So let's go. So through our life, everybody moves and uses their face in different ways. Some are more expressive, some are more calm, and this translates on how we look, actually. You can have a look at older people who used to be positive people and kind, and even though they will have wrinkles, which I'm absolutely not against, they will look nice, their face looks balanced out, and it's kind of nice to look at them generally. While other people who maybe experienced a lot of hardship or were negative Nancys generally in their life, you will see a lot of things happening in their face. And this is the exact same thing also when it comes to facial asymmetry. So how we are using our face has a huge impact on how we look in the long run. So if you, for example, have a tendency to raise one eyebrow more constantly, then this will obviously make one side of the eye more strong. And this creates imbalances. And this is the same with smiling or using other parts of the face differently. So one side tends to become stronger than the other. And then we have imbalances where one side appears more droopy while the other pulls more up because it's just stronger. So let's talk about the 6 daily habits which you can already put awareness towards to improve your facial asymmetry. The first one, I cannot stress it enough, is chewing. You probably heard me talk about this on my TikTok constantly, but ask yourself, do you maybe have a favorite side you chew on? Because obviously we are eating every day, and if you chew only on one side, you are engaging the masseter muscle, which is one of our stronger muscles in the face, more than the other. And what happens over time is that this muscle becomes stronger. You not only appear more bulky on one side, but also, since all the little muscles in the face are interconnected with each other or even layered on top of each other, this muscle will pull everything towards itself. And so in the end, we have one side pulling more up while the other is more droopy. So what can you do about this? So to work on that, you can obviously put awareness towards your chewing habits and try to balance it out. This can have a huge impact in the long run. So not only it gives you more awareness while you eat, which is also very important because oftentimes we're just stressed and just shovel food into our mouth without even being aware of what we are eating, we can start putting more awareness towards the other side to balance it out, which will give you a more symmetrical face in the long run. Second bad habit when it comes to facial asymmetry is, how are you sitting when you're, for example, studying, working, or reading at a desk? Are you maybe resting your head oftentimes like this into your hand only on one side? This creates strength around this area right here and a push motion, which then also in the end creates certain imbalances in your jawline. And in order to combat that, the best thing is to either balance this out or not to do it at all. Third bad habit, and while we're already talking about sitting, is sitting cross-legged on a chair or wherever you are, like maybe commuting on the train. Because what happens if you are sitting cross-legged on your chair is that the pelvis is not evenly distributed, therefore the spine, which is aligned in the middle of your pelvis, is crooked and goes up like that, maybe goes in an S curve, and that has a big translation into your neck. I already made a video about the neck, which I will link below in the description, but as we know, the neck is something like the gateway to our face. So if the neck is not even, your face has the tendency also to balance out strength, and therefore it'll cause facial asymmetry. So try to not only sit cross-legged on a chair, but preferably also with an open chest, shoulders back, so your neck is straight. Let's get to the fourth habit, which causes facial asymmetry. And this is carrying a bag on one side. Ask yourself, do you have maybe a favorite side on which you carry your bag on? Or if you go to the grocery store and always have a tendency to carry the bag on one side? I honestly had that. And this caused having one shoulder stronger than the other. And so my shoulder on which I was carrying bags on was not only tilted down, but it also was very tense. And then while the other was pulling up to compensate a little bit. So overall, this will then create a tense neck, which then also translates in the asymmetry of the face. So try to balance out on which side you are carrying your bag, or even better, get yourself a backpack if you are carrying bags for a longer period of time, because then the weight is distributed evenly onto your back and you will not have these strength imbalances in your neck and therefore in your face. Let's get to the fifth habit on what causes facial asymmetry. And this is when we are standing, waiting maybe for the train or for a friend and shifting our weight on one side of the leg. Probably sounds familiar. And again, this causes to strengthen one side of the body, whereas the other is leaning casually, maybe not engaged at all. And therefore, this causes strength imbalances in the body. And overall, what happens in the body is a translation into our faces. So this is why also I talk always about the posture and why it's important to work on your neck and work on your spine, because this is a direct translation on how your face looks. So when you're waiting for your friend or when you're standing around, try to balance the weight out and stand evenly on 2 feet. And lastly, the sixth bad habit when it comes to facial asymmetry is overexpressing ourselves. Or you might have some signature face moves, which you are doing regularly, which cause imbalances in the strength of the face. And this can be maybe raising an eyebrow and therefore one eyebrow is more up than the other. Or you are smirking a lot, like with your face or with your mouth, and this pulls up one side more up than the other. And then again, you will create facial asymmetry and imbalances in strength. So overall, what you need to understand, you need to use your face evenly and also use your body evenly when you are going through life, because again, this is then how your face in the end will look like. So what can you do at home to work on your facial asymmetry? First of all, balance all activities out. Then, second of all, work on your spine. Strengthen everything in the core to become more stronger and even out imbalances. Also, when you work out, you need to realize maybe you have a tendency to have a weaker side, so try to engage that more. If you do facial exercises and strengthen the muscles, then you can also do more repetitions on the weaker side by holding down the stronger side. So if you, for example, are having one eyebrow which is very active and moving up more than the other, then hold it down and try to engage the weaker side more. So you have more repetitions on the weaker side, or also when doing, for example, cheek exercises, try to really firmly hold that cheek with one hand and work on the weaker side more. And overall, it also helps when exercising your face and engaging the muscles to visualize the muscles. So if you feel you have a weaker side or a tendency to have a droopier side, then try to visualize that side more and give it more strength while working out. Next thing, if you do feel one side is stronger than the other, try also to release tension in that area, because oftentimes when we have stronger muscles in our face, this means that they're most likely also very tense. So if you have, for example, a very strong jaw on one side, try to release the tension. Obviously, it helps to do it on both sides, but really give some special love to the stronger side of your face to release the tension in the face and make the other work harder. So I hope that gave you a little glimpse in the world of facial asymmetry. There's obviously more to say about it, and I'm happy to do another video, but I think this was a great basic introduction to understand why your face could be asymmetric and what you can do about it. And overall, I have to say, the goal here is not to become evenly perfect, because None of us is, and this is the beauty of it. Everybody has their uniqueness and slight asymmetries, and you will never find a person who has a perfectly symmetrical face. And this is great. Also, all you can face is not about walking through life like this and having no wrinkles. Yes, we want to reduce wrinkles. Yes, we want to enhance our skin tone, and we want to work maybe on some issues which we find can be improved. But you also need to start liking yourself, loving yourself, and also accepting yourself. Because with that, and doing facial exercises and massages, you will have the best outcome ever. Because if you're kind to yourself, this not only translates into your face, but everything what you will do around in life. So with that being said, I hope you like this. And if you are interested in more videos about becoming the best version of you, please subscribe and hit the notification bell, and I'll see you next week.